We welcome you inside Griffin Center Arena. Two teams coming off two different results a night ago are set to clash on a Saturday in the Royal City. The Guelph Gryphons off a 10-4 win against the RMC Paladins, while the Queens Gaels fell 6-0 to the Brock Badgers. Brock falling to 4-1 on the year. Guelph gaining a win to go move to 2-2. Anthony Popovich makes his return to Guelph in the Queens goal. Tanner Wickware guards the pipes in the Guelph goal. Drew Jackson takes over the puck. He's the referee along with Aaron Neely, Ryan Moore, Logan Joyce are on the lines, and we are underway. Thanks for tuning in on Griff Vision as part of OUA TV. I'm Jeffrey Brando. Happy you could join us, no matter what part of the world you are living in. Deflected back out to the neutral zone, and Jackson Camp is the first on it. Off the leg of Emmett Gordon, Duncan Penman will race to the far side. Gordon puts it right on the stick of a Queens player, but he'll recover his own pass. Gain the red, gain the blue. Hunter Brazier's with him. The trailer is Camp and hops over his stick. Camp a goal and assist last night in that win over RMC. Jack Duff takes a hit, makes the play. Anthony Tabak with the bone-crushing blow. Now Dalton Duhart had a three-game point streak where he scored 4 points in each of them. The league's leading scorer, Daniel Michaud from Belleville in his first season, the former Niagara Ice Dog. And Oshawa Generals taken over here by Forrester, late of the Acadie Bathurst Teton. Tristan DeYoung, a shot from the outside. That's deflected away by Popovich. Forrester will leave this for Winterton. Winterton all the way back to DeYoung, but it goes too far for Ham, and now Liam Ham will have to recover. Ham makes a move to the line, drops the puck for nobody in particular, and Hayden Fowler will take over. Dishes for Hamilton. Hamilton a try! Skims the outside of the post. Hamilton's right back in. The Kingston native, three assists on the season, all in the first game against Ontario Tech. Longo sees that spinning puck turned over to DeSimone. Luke Kukovicius takes over. Kukovicius has that shot swallowed up by Anthony Popovich. 2:05 into the first frame. The save by Popovich in his fourth year out of Belleville. As mentioned, making a return to Guelph. He played here for 3 years and 1 year with the Flint Firebirds, winning the J. Ross Robertson Cup in 2019, as well as Owen Lalonde in really the greatest comeback in hockey history. Jonah DeSimone, formerly of Gatineau, and Niagara as well, as they score! Referees will talk about this. There you see DeSimone. It's in off Popovich. DeSimone has scored twice in back-to-back games. This would be his fifth of the season if it stands. Tristan DeYoung and Jack Duff want to have a word with Aaron Neely and Drew Jackson as they decide on a goal, and it will be waved off. Net is off the moorings as the puck crosses the line over Anthony Popovich, and there you see the explanation from Neely to Josh Dixon. For those in Queens that may be unfamiliar with the posts around here in Griffin Center Arena, they are not that strong. You will see more than a few times in this game the net come off its positioning and play having to stop. Queens was really upset with their starts this year. Talking with Coach Brett Kipson beforehand, said they really have to work on their starts. They nearly went down 1-0, 3 minutes, not even, into this contest. They're without Holden Catalay, who got injured in the game in Brock within the first 5 minutes, and they weren't able to recover. Popovich will glove that. The shot from Isaac DeYoung, or Tristan DeYoung, excuse me. Gio Biondi with a few words, not unlike his style of play. The Sudbury native who had two assists last night. Ethan Doyle in on the draw against Duhart. Pittman, a wrist shot, gets through the rebound as Doyle is all over Popovich. And again, the net falls off its moorings. Griffins won't be able to change. As there you see the wrist shot from Pittman. Lalonde pushing his opponent into Popovich, knocking off the net. And Queens will win the subsequent defensive draw. Nolan Hutchinson takes over. Hutchinson, his drive is held on to by Tanner Wickware, the Kingston native in his third season, who had 4 goals in the first game this year against Ontario Tech, and that's a good job also by Tanner Wickware in case there was any rebounds to end up wide of the cage and not sit out juicily in front. This is the second game of two today here at Gryphon Center Arena. For those watching us live on Grip Vision as part of OUA TV, the Griffins women handled the Nipissing Lakers women by a score of 6-1 this afternoon. So we'll see if those posts play a part, as there was also a practice in between the two. Doyle doesn't see that until it comes to his stick. Finally, he'll make a change to back and forth still. Will come on. There's Allenson, the Waterloo native, to the Breslau native, and DeYoung, and he'll reverse it for the defender with the 6 most points in Barry Colt's history. Here is Winterton. Winterton, a try. That's negated at the point of attack, and now Hamilton will lead this rush. Back to the line. Stevenson sets it up and into the glove of the Milton native, who's 1-2 this year with a 2.37 goals against average and a 931 save percentage. The economics major with a slap shot in his second season. Guelph will go with their scoring line on a defensive zone draw. Here's Luke Kukovicius losing it. Perrick has that fended off by Wickware. And now Ham. The jewel pop free. Robert takes over. Stevenson has that tipped wrong by Fowler, who then subsequently throws a roadblock separating player from puck. Michaud. Ham. Now DeSimone. who had a goal taken away a couple of minutes ago. DeSimone for Kuka. Vicious, he shoots. And Lucas Perk is out to fearlessly block that. The former alternate captain with the Kinks and Frontenacs. Driving around is Robert. He'll leave this for Lalonde. Lalonde shoots the rebound. Oh, what a save by Wickman. They score on the rebound. Alex Robert. His third goal of the season. And the Queens, Gaels, have an early 1-0 lead. 5 minutes, 43 seconds in. The former Navin grad, who is now in his fifth year, taking the applied economics course, arts and science faculty in Queens, has given his side a 1-0 lead. Darren Kapp and Owen Lalonde will get the assist as Wickware sends that into danger. Off the deflection off his pad. And now Biondi has to take an alternate route, but still cuts to the net. Duff is in the way. And here's Darren Kapp. The North Vancouver BC native will flick this in. Wickware will set this up. Jeffrey Brando with you. You're watching Gryphons as part of OUA TV. Queens just taking a 1-0 lead. 6 minutes, 30 seconds. Into the opening frame, Tristan DeYoung. Onto the stick of the Scarborough native in Gordon. Only to the Queens blue line. Guelph will take over. Pemmon will link up with Kukovicius, or big pardon, it's Doyle. He'll slap it in the rest of the way and charge after on a forecheck. Nolan Hutchison, the former Sudbury pick in 2016. Ethan Doyle rips that away. Off the skate of Gordon. Paquette will deliver this to Renwick, formerly of Windsor and Hamilton. Paquette wrists a shot on goal that's knocked away by Winware into the netting. Paquette, the Ottawa native, looking for his first goal since February 16th, 2022. Line changes for both sides. To back in on the draw, he'll face off against Hayden Fowler, another Kingston native who played 138 career OHL games with Sault Ste. Marie and Erie and had been traded to Oshawa but didn't play because of the COVID season. Gryphons off the block shot. Stevenson goes rink wide and Allenson will have to retrace. Ricocheted to Forrester. To back. Separates player from puck. There's the goal scorer in Robert. Kept in just at the line by Allenson. Fed back down. Forrester. Return pass for Allenson. Now DeYoung. Switches with Allenson. Allenson. Now taking the offensive jaunt behind the goal line, defers to Winterton. He'll go further for DeYoung. A shot that gets blocked by Michaud. Goes into the corner and back out to the neutral zone. Tristan DeYoung has got Anthony Tabak. Tabak's has room, space, and a shot on goal that's absorbed by Popovich, playing in his first game this year. 8-3-0 in his OUA career, 2.50 goals against and a 907 save percentage. Tabak looking to close, or at least continue, on a three-game point streak. Guelph will win this draw. Nolan DeGersey from Brightscove. Family in attendance for this one. DeSimone, centering pass. Kukovic just can't find the loose puck, and right will pitchfork that back in. Now a 3-on-2 is taken away here by DeGersey. A hooking call coming to Cameron Tolney. And this will be a pretty easy call for the officials. As Tolney went to get past Verbeek, or beg your pardon, DeGersey. And puts his stick right against the hip. So Guelph will go to a power play that was dynamite last night. Not so much in this game, at least the first 10 seconds into it. 4-for-6 on the power play last night. They were 1-for-13 heading in. Queens responds with a 17-for-19 penalty kill, going 4-for-4 against the Brock Badgers. 30 seconds in, Nolan DeGersey, and now Anthony Tabak. He'll lug it in, or at least to Kukovicius. DeSimone, DeYoung, DeGersey, back for DeYoung. Now DeAllenson. DeGersey recaptures this rebound. DeYoung circulates to Allenson. A backdoor pass looking for DeSimone. Again, a very aggressive penalty kill for Queens. As soon as they obtain possession, the player is flying out of the zone. DeGersey, Kukovicius, Allenson hops over his stick. Recaptured by DeSimone. DeYoung will keep this in. Reverse to Allenson. Hand it off to DeSimone. DeGersey! DeYoung. Shot knocked down by Popovich. DeYoung will race over, keep this in. 30 seconds to go. A nice little pass to DeGersey. It's blocked. And DeSimone will send that. DeSimone will send that into outer space for a whistle. Well, real good puck movement on that power play, but nothing really of anger towards the net except for that one. As Popovich must have gotten the last touch with the offensive zone draw. 25 seconds remains in the power play. Gryphons will be replaced here on the draw. Winterton will take over for Tabak. In on the draw against Cap. And now Cap will be removed. Cousins, the Sechelt PC native. As we are finally back under play. Camp, Tabak, back door. Nice save by Popovich. Cutting off either A, a shot on goal, or B, a pass to an open player. Here is Winterton representing Whitby. Penalty is expired. Springing into action is Duhart. Turns it over to Camp. Here is Tabak. Knocks it down. Tabak intended for Winterton. The pass goes through him. And Longo will chip that to the neutral zone. Pitchfork right back in by Forrester. Here is Renwick. He scored in overtime in game one of the 2022 OHL Championship Series with Windsor against his former team in the Bulldogs. Enright, a former member of the Storm who was taken 17th overall by the Niagara Ice Dogs through the skates of Doyle. And now Stevenson. Gordon. To the line, not out. Gordon will keep this in, looking for Brazier. Those two, the only two players that did not record a point in last night's rout by the Gryphons. Hutchinson. Onto the stick of Brazier. Glassed, kept in by Lalonde, the former second overall pick in the OHL priority selection. Wickwear keeps the door shut. Ham, a former member of the Mississauga Steelheads. Perrick accepts the hard pass from Lalonde. Reese distributed it down where Doyle will jump in front of it. And now Emmett Gordon, head up, sprints out to the neutral zone. Lalonde is quickly right back, infiltrating. Are the Queens Gaels approaching 7 1/4 to go in the first? Forrester, Allenson. In on Anthony Popovich, who will just settle it down for Jack Duff, who signed once an amateur tryout with the Pittsburgh Penguins. First beat in by Queens. DeYoung forces it right back out thanks to Forrester. Wilson will flip this in deep. Popovich plays this to Hamilton. Intercepted by Ferguson. Taken right back by Hamilton. Waits for a teammate in Tolmanay to get back onside. Hamilton, a drive, he scores! Right through the legs of Tanner Wickware, and Queens takes a 2-0 lead. The goal comes at 13:29. This should be unassisted. As Wickware lifted his legs just in time. And for Hamilton, that's his first goal here in the OUA. Tristan DeYoung wanted to talk something over. Perhaps again the net off the moorings on the far side. Or at least the Queens goal, inside the Queens goal. Tone will indeed get an assist on that. Cap will be removed for this faceoff, and we are back underway with Queens taking a 2-0 lead. Luke Kukovic has DeSimone in front. Can't get it to him off a beautiful defensive play by Jacob Paquette, who was on the second All-Star team last year. Wickware sees that go right past him. DeSimone, who was spliced wide open on his first OUA goal, later came back in a full birdcage to score his second into his empty net against Laurier. Penman into the paraphernalia of Marburg, the North Vancouver BC native in his first season. Doyle in a battle against Stevenson. Doyle takes the player, Stevenson takes the puck, Queens takes possession. Duhart offers this to Stevenson, recaptured in the neutral zone, offered to Michaud. Ripped away by Brazier. The transfers to Gordon, a drive through Popovich and wide. Penman, wrist shot, flung on goal. And Anthony Popovich is there to make his 10th stop of the game. The University of Guelph Department of Athletics is running a food drive during the week of October 16th to 22nd, 2023 to support the Central Student Association Food Bank. The much-in-demand Guelph Student Food Bank provides undergraduate and graduate University of Guelph students access to emergency food, anti-poverty resources, and referrals to other food, anti-poverty, and financial assistance groups. It is a critical time for the food bank, which is experiencing increased need in the wake of cost of living increases. Storage bins will be available in the Guelph Gryphons Athletic Center lobby all week, as well as at entrances to varsity games October 20th. Through 22nd, Tabak with Forrester in front. Poke checked wide. Winterton is there, as is Popovich, to shut it down. Popovich, who played one game as a backup with the Belleville Sens in February of 2022. Making a strong showing in hit hold hometown. This place looks to be at half capacity here. As the Queens Gaels meet up with the Guelph Gryphons for the first time, the 2019 Queens Cup. One that Queens won 4-1. Teams have alternated wins and losses over their last six meetings. Blockered away by Wickware. Springing Kukovicius. Pass intended for DeSimone is too far. Allenson forces Marburg off the disc. And back comes Ham. For defense partner Allenson. Out of the reach of DeSimone. Dispatched onto the stick of Hamilton. And now Cameron Tolney. The former sixth overall pick by the Ottawa 67s back in 2018. Jonah DeSimone will send this into the Queen zone where a fair pair of former Storm teammates will launch an attack on the Gryphons. Paquette knocked down. Michaud in front. Wickware's got it. And will hold on as Queen's starting to buzz around the cage. Looking for their third. Already seen one goal deflected in into that net earlier today. Queens, the highest scoring team in the league, having scored 24 of them, six in the league in shots on goal. Doyle in on the draw against the Grand Blanc native. Our Grand Blanc native of Michigan in Dewhart, and a penalty. And this will come to Lalonde, I believe. It'll go for high sticking as we wait for the offensive player to go, and it's going to go to Ethan Doyle. We sort of can't believe it's luck. It's off the draw. And I believe it should be 71 Brazier instead. But we'll be talking about this a little bit further from Josh Dixon to Aaron Neely. Two goals in the period, one at 5:43. That off the stick of Alex Robert. And Derek Hamilton, his first in the OUA, is the other. So Queens will go to the power play. They're 5-for-19 this year. The same number as the Gryphons, an 0-for-4 last night. Gryphons power play is 10, or power play kill is 10-for-13. Fowler skips into the offensive zone. Dewhart continues the progress. He'll link up with Lalonde. Lalonde will send it towards the goal. It'll be deflected wide. Yancis, who scored 50 goals with the Kitchener Rangers, working his offensive prowess, standing in front of the goal. Lalonde continues to Fowler. Fowler's shot stopped by Camp. The rebound, they score! Alex Robert, the second of the period. And the power play goal connects at 17:29, 4 minutes after their last goal to give the Queens Gaels a 3-0 lead. Wickware just can't reach that far post in enough time. And the next draw will occur at center ice. Fowler, the only assist on that, as Robert now has his 11th career goal in 48 games in the OUA. Kukovicius comes right back with a fireball. That's turned away by Popovich. 2 minutes to go in the first. Queens with a 14-12 shots on goal lead. Nolan DeGersey with DeSimone. DeSimone recaptures and will fling it in deep. We're winning it as Stevenson. He'll connect with Camp, or Cap. Michaud from the outside into the chest pad of Wickware, the former Cherry Cup champion with the Cambridge Redhawks in 2021-2022. Queen just forcing everything to the net, making sure Wickware has to make the save. Tolnai didn't drop his stick on the false faceoff. And so we'll wait for another one. As Tabak will dig in for the Gryphons. DeYoung and Allenson. Winterton. Hamilton does a flyby on him. Taken by Tolnai. Tabak dashes, chips, tries to chase, has to take an alternate route thanks to the lawn. Allenson will keep this one in. Michaud puts on the stick of Forrester. That hits the outside of the cage. Forrester captures his own offensive rebound. Allenson deflected to the net, reeled in by Popovich with 66 remaining seconds remaining in the first. There you look at Alex Robert, the former North Bay draft pick who was the CCHL All-Rookie Team in 2017 and Academic All-Star in 2020. He's put up a pair matching his season total. Duhart will flip this towards the goal. It's knocked away by Wickware. Camp will knock this down with his hand, pick it up with his stick. Yantzis will fling this back in deep. Penman reverses course, distributes to Gordon. He'll dispatch Camp. Doyle takes a hit after jarring that puck free. And a whistle perhaps hitting the beams here at Griffin Center Arena. Camp, the Ottawa native, son of Sean Camp, the former longtime head coach of the Gryphons, who retired after last season. DeYoung, a drive from the point, received well and into the glove of Popovich. That evens up the shots in the period, 15-all. Tolnai will come in on the draw, replacing Fowler. And it's won by Queens. Allenson off the indirect pass is captured by DeGersey. And now the race is on. Marburg will outrace DeYoung. They'll do battle. DeYoung will win the mano a mano. DeGersey, lead pass for DeSimone. Icing will be called on the other side with 2 seconds left. We keep an eye on Anthony Popovich to see if he stays in the cage. He'll come off for an 8 late extra attacker. with exactly 2 seconds left. Now Luke Kukovic is looking for a word with Aaron Neely. Fowler in on the draw. Renwick, Duff, Lalonde. They actually had three defenders out there. Renwick tries to put this to the net, but it hits the conglomeration of bodies in front, and that will do it for the first period of play. Alex Robert scored his first at 5:43, followed by Derek Hamilton, the first in of his OUA career at 13:29. Robert's got his second. Connecting on a power play at 17:29 of the period. Shots through one are tied at 15 apiece. We are through one period of play from Gryphons Center Arena and the Queens Gaels lead 3-0. Back with more in a moment. You are watching Gryphision as part of OUA TV.
Welcome to the inaugural and the first of many diversity in sports conference. Congratulations to everybody for making this all become a reality.
I would highly recommend that people within the sport landscape in Canada definitely come out to this conference next year. There's so much good information that can be absorbed from here, and I think we can all be part of the change within Canada if we all actively engage in conversations like this.
Coming to the Diversity and Sports Conference was one of the best experiences I ever had after coming to Canada. The people I was able to meet, the people I was able to network with, the friends I made, and the learnings I gained were tremendous.
Sign up right now. Follow them on whatever social media platform they are. Email the OUA, contact them, contact whoever you need to contact, find out when they're getting ticket sales again, and get here. This is a must do every single year. Everyone needs to be here. We need to pack this place and get at it again in 2024.
We don't have to work alone. We can do this together. And it shows by the numbers that are here that we want to improve and we want to make a better future for all Canadians. Doesn't matter where they're from, but that's the goal that we have. So thank you so much for coming to the inaugural conference, and dare I say, see you next year.
Where exceptional student athletes are born, where records are broken, where great plays are made, where school colors ignite passion, where champions prevail, where tradition is celebrated, Ontario University Athletics.
One of the most influential times of my life, and not just in hockey. You know, I made the national team playing for the University of Guelph, and you know, got to be coached by one of the all-time greatest players, and Sue Shear, you know, the first captain, and it shaped me. You come here and you're with older players and players who have, you know, been training a little bit longer than you have, and you know, you didn't know about these girls, you didn't know about other great players, and you know, I remember I was the only one that ever made the national team from this program at that time, but it wasn't because other players couldn't have. I think it was just, you know, just the way it kind of fell. But I learned more about myself and about how to be a better person, you know, how to, you know, push myself physically and mentally, you know, by playing at the University of Guelph, more so than anywhere else I played. So it was really, really impactful for me to be here and to be able to play here. It taught me about hard work and balance, and you know, I had a job up at Gryphons, and you know, I was a student and an athlete, and just the, trying to have fun at the same time, and you know, trying to find that balance with your athletics and you know, your student life. The Guelph taught me how to do that for the rest of my career, leading into broadcasting. You know, now you can fill hockey schools with young girls all the time, all across the country, and I think access to a professional-like atmosphere that's fun for kids and appropriate for minor hockey, but you know, people take women's hockey seriously now, and they're pushing their daughters and giving them the opportunities to be the best player that they can be. And that was things that I never really had growing up. You kind of had to push yourself, and you had to find ways to get better, and you'd play with the boys to try and get better. And you know, now these girls have access to some pretty high technology and you know, high expertise people around them, and so many great teams to play against. I had three, so it's really changed a lot. You look at the national program, and everyone was a captain or assistant on their club teams, and you know, I was lucky enough really to be chosen, and it's an easy group to lead, and but you have a lot of responsibility, you know, and you just, you have to be humble, you have to be willing to do whatever it takes to win and play any role. And you know, for me, it wasn't about being always the best player, but it was about being a player that could play first line, I played defense, I played fourth line, I played third line, and you know, just being willing to do whatever it took to win. And I think being willing to sacrifice, you know, some of your personal successes for that of the team, and that's always worth it in the end. I think here at the University of Guelph, first and foremost, you're going to get a great education, a broad education. There's so many programs here that you can take, especially that first year when you're so unsure, you know, what you want to do. And I think, you know, for 20, 30 years now, they've supported female athletics. Like when I was here, it wasn't just women's hockey. The women's soccer team was great. The women's basketball team was great. And, you know, they really were inclusive. And of course, it's grown up and it's gotten a lot even more inclusive over the years. But it's just a terrific program, not just in sports, but also making sure you get a good education at the same time. I think the impact that She's Got Game will have is that the decision makers are going to have to abide by what She's Got Game stands for. And, you know, hopefully women's sports benefits from it. And that this isn't just a one-year thing. This is something that's going to be long-term, and it's going to have long-term impact. And, you know, and those are the types of initiatives I like to be involved in.
It's a hockey-defining moment. Many hear the call. Only a few ever answer it. But those who do vow to bravely defend the world's smallest kingdom, the 24 square feet of a hockey net. Every time you go in net, so do we.
Alone, I'm the last line of defense.
I am the difference. We are in net.
I started swimming lessons when I was tiny. I was about 3 years old, and I started competing at the age of six, and I never stopped.
My best friend started playing hockey, and she's kind of what got me into playing hockey, so I just kind of fell in love with hockey.
I started playing basketball when I was 6 years old, I think, maybe six or seven. Throughout high school, I always knew I wanted to play post-secondary. On my visit up here, I knew right away that this was where I wanted to spend the next 4 or 5 years. And I didn't even consider any other schools once I had started the recruiting process.
I was coached by men my entire swimming career, but I definitely would have loved to have a female coach around.
Boys at school, they always say, oh, boy hockey is better. And I don't say it, but I feel like if we played girls against boys, the girls could win because we're as good as boys.
Coming from Brantford, I trained with pretty much all boys. I didn't really have a team of women surrounding me or a big team atmosphere in general. So coming to Guelph was a big difference for me.
Back at Gryphons Center Arena, the Queens Gaels have a 3-0 lead as we get set to play for the second period. Let's take a look at some of the highlights. It starts here with Jordan DeSimone bouncing one in off goaltender Anthony Popovich, but ruled eventually no goal as the net had come off its moorings. There you catch the first of Alex Robert in this for this Queens team, followed by Derek Hamilton, and now the second rebounded. Wickware can't reach the net in enough time. Shots tied, 15 apiece through that first period of play. Guelph coach Scott Simmons was a little bit concerned after about the final 20 minutes where Guelph gave up a handful of goals, 3 goals against RMC. And it sort of spoiled over here into this first frame against what you would have to consider to be a little bit better competition. Dalton Newhart, Ethan Doyle do the duel to start us off here in this second period. Glad you can join us no matter what part of the world you are living in. Duncan Pinman, all the way back. He had 2 assists in that game last night. Hopping over the stick of Duff. He'll track that down, but it'll go for icing. Whole bunch of action thus far on the day for the Gryphons. A 27-29 loss to Carlton erases them from opportunity to win a football game or a football playoff game. The women's soccer team defeats Algoma, and the women's rugby team continues to run roughshod over their opponents with a 50-0 win over Brock. Hutchinson rings it off the iron as Queens comes ever closer to once again expanding their scoring lead. Duhart, a shot from the outside, easily held by Tanner Wickware. The shot here from Duhart is on, but not before Nolan Hutchinson, who just had a 4-game point streak snapped in the game last night against Brock. He rings one off the post as Queens is back to take control. Marburg back for Paquette, out of the reach of Renwick. It'll end up on the stick of Hamilton. He'll offer to Renwick. Allenson maintains control. DeYoung delivers to the stick of Forrester. Turned right back, and this will be icing. Stevenson, the Ottawa native, just recently turned 24 years old. The number one overall pick by the Cumberland Grads in the CCHL back in 2014. Tone gets a caution and subsequently wins that draw. And here comes Queens on a quick breakout. Michael Renwick fires this cross corner. Tone Tabac will take this over. A former member of the Barry Colts as well as Sudbury Wolves and Sarnia Sting. Tone. Well, turn this over to Tristan DeYoung. Makes a move. Bursts into the offensive zone thanks to Jacob Winterton, excuse me. His brother Ryan led all players in the OHL playoffs last year win points, and we'll have a whistle for a cross-checking penalty coming against the Queens Gaels. Penalty at 1:59 of the period. Guelph goes to their second power play. As there you see Tabac has his numbers showing to Trevor Longo and the North Vancouver BC native who played parts of 3 seasons with Medicine Hat in Vancouver. He'll sit for 2 minutes or less in the sin bin. A drop pass from Nathan Allenson to Luke Kukovicius. And Kukovicius will carry the luggage into the offensive zone. It's stopped by Nolan DeGersey off his stick. And nearly off of Josh Dixon. DeGersey, the GOGHL West All-Star Team and Sportsmanship Award winner in 2019-2020. Played a couple of years with the Sarnia Sting. Again, Sarnia had 4 overagers at one point, and all of them have ended up in Guelph. Again, at one point, as a shot here drilled wide by Jacob Paquette. Christopher was in with RMC last night. Seven shorthanded goals for last year. Tone punched that away, or at least the defender punches that away from the goal. Tristan DeYoung looking for DeGuercy. It's too far, and it will go for icing with 50 seconds left in the power play. Ashton Reeser, the first of those, being traded from Sarnia to Guelph in a trade between the Sting and Storm, followed by, or at least Cameron Saprika was first. Reeser and Braden Guy will follow. And then Nolan DeGuercy comes over and joins the University of Guelph Gryphons. And he's on the ice now and got the puck. And DeGuercy will walk this down to Kuka Vicious, and he scores! Luke Kuka Vicious is fourth in two games. And the lead is cut from 3-2. DeGuercy finds Kukovicius in front. DeYoung should get the other assist. That goal coming at 4:27. And Guelph responds with an own power play goal of their own. 14th power play goal, or 14th overall goal in his career for Luke Kukovicius. Duff will swing this towards the cage. And now Penman. Gordon, drilled by Duff, keeps his feet moving. Doyle is there, as is Duff. Duhart rips it wide. As Dalton Duhart had time, space, and ability, but just couldn't beat Tanner Wickwer. Jack Duff sees that swallowed up and does a flyby. He's tripped up on the way. But Guelph gets back within two. Another Kingston native in Jack Duff, this time in his third season. Captained the Erie Otters, and he won the Steve Nimigon Award for dedication to the Erie community. 25 and 20 in on the draw. That's Fowler and Wilson. Here's Wilson, a wrist shot, chased away by Anthony Popovich. Michaud, and pass intended for Robert. Here's Fowler. Fowler, a backhander into the body of Wickwear. Paquette has his stick explode. The stick part, the blade part, nearly took off the linesman's head. Ended up, thankfully, in the bench. Nobody's hurt down there. Isaac Enright. Kukovicius. With 5 minutes gone in the second, Kukovicius wheels. Puts this on to Gersi, and again, Forsers there, they score! Nolan DeGuercy! Catches Anthony Popovich off guard. The goal comes at 15:04. Kukovicius should get one assist. He set up DeGuercy. Shots now 19-19. And Guelph gets the start that they need. Shots tied at four this period. Guelph with a 2-0 goals edge. For DeGuercy, that's his. as Wickware finds it through the traffic. And we'll get a freeze, 5:30 in. There you see the shot come in on goal, and Wickware swallows that up in his 13th career OUA game, 3.28 goals against average and a 9.07 save percentage. Goals come less than 30 seconds apart. As Kukovicius gets the first, DeGuercy gets the second on a changeup. And Guelph attacks, looking for a third. Doyle loses this to Olin Lalonde. Lalonde, who played in Guelph with Ryan Merkley the first time, the first and second overall picks have played in the OHL prior to this for the same team since the first time since the 1980s. Dalton Duhart pushes this out to the neutral zone. Camp will boomerang that right back in. Renwick. Renwick from the outside. Again, just misses. This shot is nullified by Wilson. He'll only get it to Longo, who will botch this. Biondi will take over only for a second, as Marburg will race in. Here is Marburg, one-on-one with Allinson. Marburg falls, causes a turnover. Wilson takes a bump. Stevenson takes the puck, fires it towards the goal. Again, pinballing around to the stick of Cap. Stevenson links up with Perica with a fastball. And Marburg is on the ice, and he looks to be in some serious difficulty here. Marburg takes a check there. Looked rather innocuous, but the former Pacific Junior Hockey League champion with the North Vancouver Wolfpack, who also played a couple of seasons with the Humboldt Broncos, may have got that in a sensitive spot in the back where there's no padding. Faceoff comes 7:01 with the second period of play. There's a pall over the Gryphon Center Arena. It looks like Marburg will be joined by Perrick and Michaud. And a couple of Gryphon trainers as well, perhaps. Back to his feet is Marburg, but not really putting any weight on any body part. Let's see how he looks coming off. Queens have had a couple of unfortunate injuries in this arena. Last year, a Queens player on the women's side happened to hit their head on the ice, which caused a disruption. Luckily, she seemed to be okay. And we hope for the best for Samuel Marburg, the arts and sciences student. Stevenson with a wrist shot, again into the crew of bodies, knocked away by Wickware, as Queens tries to pick up the intensity. Stevenson accepts, puts this on the stick of Perrick. He continues the chain to Hamilton, who's looking for his second. Allenson. Now Biondi. This is Biondi. He's got Wilson and Forrester with him, as well as DeYoung, and a shot is on. And he chases after their own rebound, not to the dislike of Derek Hamilton. There you look at Nolan DeGersey. Again, representing Brightsgrove in his second year. Had a goal and three assists in the game against RMC last night. Luka Gavicius in on the draw, had the inverse, the first hat trick for the Guelph Gryphons men's side since Gio Fornaro in January of 2020. This deflected right to Kukavicius. Wants to return it to DeSimone, can't do it. And re-infiltrating are Queens. Enright forces Cousins. Now Enright seems to be in a little bit of difficulty. DeSimone is knocked off stride by Duff. Ham will track back and outrace Cousins for a whistle. .824 gone in the second. Jeffrey Brando with you. You are watching Gryphon as part of OUA TV. Queens with three in the first. Gryphons with two in the second. Ham. That hits Lalonde. Ferguson will keep this in. Lalonde will step in the way of that. Kukavicius bats this down to DeGersey. A return pass for Kukavicius. Looking for DeSimone. DeGersey takes over. Nolan DeGersey on the left wing. Takes the alternate route. Ham has his shot taken away. Now Kukavicius. Kukavicius for DeGersey. Duff is the roadblock. And back comes the Queens Gaels. Tone is offside. A player for the Gaels. Just a little bit too quick in gaining the line and then peeling off to the bench. Duhart on the draw, and we'll take off the win from Doyle. Renwick, rung around. Duhart is there, knifed back by Gordon. Now Camp will just glass this. It'll die at the feet of Renwick. Brazier causes him some havoc. Doyle throws a hit on Paquette, a bouncing puck. Won by Popovich, but it ends up behind the goal. Behind the goal, excuse me. Hunter Brazier will fire this down for Camp. Boomeranging around over the stick of Brazier. Penman pinches down. Recovered by Doyle. Penman falls. Tripped up by Duhart. It'll swing to Hutchinson. Brazier re-infiltrates. And now Renwick. Stevenson. Duhart can't claim this. Puck is kept in at the line. Winterton wraps this around. Tristan DeYoung. Allenson, Winterton, Allenson again. Lost it, regains possession. Tristan DeYoung to the line, it's Winterton. Guelph working the cycle here, looking for an offensive opportunity. Allenson sees that taken away by Forrester. Allenson fakes, still can't unleash. Being watched there by the big body and Jonathan Yancis. The shot is on goal. Headed towards, at least. It's knocked away by Paquette. Winterton, head up. Reverses for Forrester. Forrester, now DeYoung. Swung to Allenson. Taken over is Forrester. offers to DeYoung, back for Forrester, and Anthony Popovich, who is swimming a little bit in the crease with a puck movement, comes over and makes a save. Anthony to back, he scores! Gryphons have tied the game! Anthony Tabak is second of the season. And that's just a goal set up by hard work. An offensive possession. And the Gryphons. Have tied the game and taken a 22-21 shots on goal lead. That was the shift they've been looking for all year long. 30 plus seconds, maybe even a minute of offensive zone work as Tanner Wickwear again loses his footing and will jump on the loose grenade with Hamilton searching for it in the crease. But again, it's what the Gryphons needed to tie the game. Queens tried to work their own little bit of offensive magic. Wickwear doing some DIY work, chewing up the ice in front of him as he has to make a wild save. We'll redo this face-off with 8:02 to go. Tonight in on the draw. Wilson. Biondi. Shot from the outside. Does not bother Popovich. Ham. Sends it towards the net and he scores! Liam Ham, the first of the season and third of his career. And just like the Gryphon women a couple of hours ago, who scored four in the period, in the second period, the Gryphons do the same, the men's side, and now have a lead, and that will replace Anthony Popovich with Aiden Spooner. Thank you. A 6'7" goaltender in his second season from Maple, Ontario. And the crowd here has come alive. Enright and Forrester on the assist. Turn right back by DeSimone. Here's Jonah DeSimone. DeGuercy keeps it forward. And now behind the goal, a bad bounce off a player of Queens. Robert is stymied by Ferguson. 7 minutes to go in the frame. Jeffrey Brando with you. You are watching Gryphvision as part of OUA TV. Queens with offensive possession. Shot blocked by Ethan Doyle. Longo lost the handle. Returns this to Renwick, and a headhunter smashes off the glass. Here is Trevor Longo, who played in the Memorial E-Cup with the Vancouver Giants during the COVID session in 2021. Onside, Duhart deflected right on, and Tanner Wickwear with the save that he needs. One of the more difficult stops he's had to make. Anthony Popovich left to wonder what went wrong. A seeing eye drive from Ham. It looks like Forrester got his stick in the lane. to take the puck away from the eyes of Popovich. Forrester and Winterton off the lost draw. Spooner will find it and freeze it. The first overall pick by the Frontenacs in the 2019 U18 priority selection. Queens again, another draw one. To back over to disturb Michaud. Allenson will swing this back. Tristan DeYoung. Forrester grabs the handle, throws it in. Stevenson will put it on the stick of Tolnay. Michaud with Cap with him. And a penalty coming. It'll be a slashing call. At 14-12, it'll be Forrester who goes for the Gryphons. So the Queens Gaels get a shot on the power play. There you see a little slash on the hands, but it causes the turnover. And that's the foul that is detected by the referees. Here is Robert on hat-trick watch after two first-period goals. He has a chance, and oh, what a save! Blasting the leather is Tanner Wickware to keep this game in a one-goal lead for his home side. All alone is the dead spot is the Queen's shooter. Wickware well out to read it, and he makes a phenomenal save. Fowler asked to be replaced by Duhart. Penman fires that right off the bricks of the arena. There you take a look at Nathan Allison and Tristan DeYoung. DeYoung with two assists tonight as he extends an assist streak to four games. Bad turnover. Penman's lost his stick. Griffin Wilson will give him his. Robert to the top, it's the lawn. Robert returns it, and Wickware is there with the denial. Wilson on a short 5-on-3 as he goes to fetch a stick of his own. This is Fowler. Fowler will go behind the cage, leaves this for Robert. Robert has a chance to walk down with it. Robert! The rebound, and Wickware's got it. Exactly a minute left to go in the power play. But Queens getting ever closer to tying this game up. Josh Dixon wanted an interference call. Aaron Neely says no. Not in my opinion. 4 3/4 left in the second. Queens now have a 26-24 shots on goal lead as this puck is iced. And Aiden Spooter will have to play it. He'll leave this for Lalonde. 2021 OUA East first all-star team. Lalonde follows it away on through. Puck still free! Where is it? Goal is waved off, and now we've got a major skirmish between two teams that are as heated as possible. You have to believe that Queens is very much upset by the way that this game is gone. Meanwhile, Guelph trying their best to defend the honor of their goalkeeper, and another Queens Gale is down. Once again, the tie up behind the cage. You see the immediate wave off from referee Drew Jackson, and then Yontzis leaves his feet and really it's all going on behind the cage. So we'll wait for the official calls as Aaron Neely and Drew Jackson have some work to do. Luke Kikovicius scored at the 4:27 mark of the period on the power play to give Guelph a chance to cut the lead from 3-0 to 3-1. Nolan DeGersey follows at 5:04. Anthony DeBack ties the aim at 11:21, and Liam Hamm a seeing eye shot at 12:10. And that is Guelph's, all of their goals, all their four goals here in their frame. We're gonna have a differential of 5-on-4, or at least 4-on-4, as Hayden Fowler will sit an extra 2 minutes in the sin bin. Face-off will take place inside the Queen zone to the glove hand of Eden Spooner. So 4-on-4. Back quickly comes Queens. The rush is led by Tolnai. And now Camp in a little bit of difficulty behind the goal. Jacob Winterton, a drive from the outside. Centers this up, turns this over to Tolnai. Camp back in the play. Tabak is leg whipped to the ice. Renwick tees this up, and it's saved by Tanner Wickware. 6 seconds now of 4-on-4 action. As Michael Renwick, in his first season, former member for 3 games of the Orlando Solar Bears. Faceoff won by Queens. DeYoung, Allinson, back on the ice is Forrester. Guelph has a power play opportunity, which is already a third done. DeSimone. Guelph 1-for-2 on the penalty kill thus far. Erased is Allinson by Hamilton, and now Duhart. Drop pass for Paquette. Kicked away by Wickware. The rebound hops over the stick of Duhart. He'll track back. Take down a loose puck. Allinson will defer to DeYoung. It's off his stick. Turns this back. Here's a drive from the outside. It hits mask of Tanner Wickware, who has to drop his mask. There you see the drop pass and the shot. The rebound hops over the stick of Dalton Duhart, who played for London, Barry, and Saginaw, including an alternate captain in his last year, 222 career OUA games. He's been a breakthrough player, says Brett Gibson, the head coach now in his 17th year behind the bench of the Queens Gaels. This Queens Gaels team has 20 former OHL graduates. TMU is 19. Meanwhile, Guelph is third in the league at 15. The OHL well represented here in this game and here throughout the OUA and the rest of USports. A false face-off, so we'll do it again. Tolnai in the draw against Tabac. Penman with 3 minutes to play. Links up with Winterton. The pass goes through the legs of Forrester and reaches camp. He'll turn this over to the lawn. Penman can't keep it in. Wickwear is out. To try to elude Cousins. Again, wreaking havoc. Very strong, very aggressive penalty kill, this Queens Gaels team. Lalonde will chip this back. Stevenson is there. Dying seconds of the penalty. Fowler will rejoin the play. Wickwear eludes the oncoming forecheck of Hamilton. Looking for DeSimone, who will win the race for an icing call. Back quickly comes Duhart. Hutchinson is in there as well. And now Tabac, the game's tying goal scorer with two to go in the frame. Jacob Winterton, as DeSimone can't take his lunge too far. And the penalized players, they're offsetting minors, will rejoin the play. Luke Kukovicius and Alex Robert. From the draw, Gryphons obtain possession. Perrick has to turn through the skates of Gordon. Flashing on the drive is Enright. And now Yantis will take over. Duhart, drop pass. There's Ethan Doyle, the whippy native. Assists in back-to-back games for him. And icing was called. Queen starting to take over the shots on goal clock now, 30-24. As Queen's matches their 15 shots from the first period. Aiden Spooner went 10-6 with the Kingston Frontenacs in 19 games played. Doyle again, in on the draw. Wickware will find it and freeze it. Guelph has a chance to change. DeGuercy will go out. DeSimone will go out. Kukovicius will do the same. Camp and Penman will replace the defenders. Robert, Tolnai, Hamilton, Longo, and Renwick. Renwick, a wrist shot, punched away by Wickwear, jammed home, at least attempted to. And now Renwick will have to retrace his steps. DeGuercy will keep this in. Robert will sweep this to the neutral zone. Here's Cameron Tolnai. Longo, looking for Robert, Camp. And now DeGuercy, Guelph with an offensive jaunt, looking for Kukovicius. Renwick, a lead pass, links up with Hutchinson. Duhart will take over. Dalton Duhart with a drive. That's halted by Duncan Penman. And now DeGuercy will flip this in. Lalonde links up with Yantis, but it's ripped away from DeYoung, and a penalty coming after a slashing call to Dalton Duhart. And a unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. So this will be a 4 minute double minor to the Queen's top scorer at 18.7 left. So the penalty comes at 19-11. Guelph goes to their fourth power play of the affair. They are 1-4-3 thus far. Jack Duff tees it up right into the belly pad of Tanner Wickwear. Duncan Penman, one last rush if Guelph wants it. Forrester will drop this back for Penman, and he'll just wait behind the cage as the penalty, or excuse me, again, the period will expire. Queens doubling Guelph in shots, 18-9 in the period, but Guelph scores four times. Luke Kukovicius at 4:27, followed by Nolan DeGersey at 5:04. Next to that is Anthony Tabak at 11:24, and Liam Hamm sends it through a group of traffic cops in front for at 12:10 to give Guelph the 4-3 lead. Through two periods of play at Gryphons Center Arena. Gryphons lead 4-3. We'll be back with more in a moment. You're watching Gryphons, part of OUA TV.
I started swimming lessons when I was tiny. I was about 3 years old, and I started competing at the age of 6, and I never stopped.
My best friend started playing hockey, and she's kind of what got me into playing hockey. So I just kind of fell in love with hockey.
I started playing basketball when I was 6 years old, I think, maybe 6 or 7. Throughout high school, I always knew I wanted to play post-secondary. On my visit up here, I knew right away that this was where I wanted to spend the next 4 or 5 years. I didn't even consider any other schools once I had started the recruiting process.
I was coached by men my entire swimming career, but I definitely would have loved to have a female coach around.
Boys at school, they always say, oh, boy hockey's better. And I don't say it, but I feel like if we played girls against boys, the girls could win because we're as good as boys.
Coming from Brantford, I trained with pretty much all boys. I didn't really have a team of women surrounding me or a big team atmosphere in general. So coming to Guelph was a big difference for me.
People are starting to notice that, like, oh, this program, this girls' basketball program is gonna be really good one day. And like same thing with volleyball, hockey. Our women's hockey team has been like amazing the past couple years, and so that hadn't really been noticed.
The rink is cold, but the arena like itself is kind of warm to me. It's kind of like a home, and it's like comfortable, and I know I can just be myself there.
Having a scholarship has like literally changed my life in the best way possible. Things would be very different if I weren't granted that opportunity, and there's funding towards female athletes, and then with that, those athletes can take those resources and like focus everything all in on their sport.
I was the swimmer who, if there was a men's standard, my standard was the men's standard. The idea behind what started this whole initiative and gearing it towards female athletics and wanting women to be able to continue in sport and have the financial means in order to be able to continue sport is just an amazing concept in of itself.
there are more and more female head coaches in different programs around Ontario. So it's definitely, we are definitely taking big steps to closing that gap and ensuring that like women in sports are more heard and more seen.
Creating this program has just allowed more female presence in athletics, which I think is so important.
I'm proud to be a Gryphon.
Welcome to the heart of Guelph, beautiful alumni stadium on the campus of the University of Guelph.
The bowling line is so worth it.
Fanoro cuts one. Templeton scores!
Ball's up. And the ball's good! She's tied the game!
She's got game.
Go crazy, Guelph! Your Gryphons are seven-time OUA champion! As I live and breathe, the unbelievable has happened.
The Guelph Gryphons have finally won a national championship.
You can't take our Gryphons
Gwyn, my name is Ben Maracle, quarterback and number 12 for the U Ottawa GGs, and I'm a First Nation Mohawk.
My name is Jethro Lako. I'm a linebacker in third year in liberal arts. I'm from Windsor, Ontario, and I'm also Congolese.
My name is Aiden Palmer. I am a fourth year student in legal studies. I play linebacker. I'm Jamaican in nationality, and I'm from Brampton, Ontario.
Growing up in Scarborough, I had many friends in grade 8 that were deemed not good enough to be in the academic stream. And many don't understand how this is a form of systematic racism. Because basically, at the young age of 13, 12, they're deeming you not good enough to go to university. This then leads you into the stream where you're in applied classes. And by the time you realize it's too late to even switch, you're now in grade 10, 11, and you're too many courses behind to even switch in to the academic stream. This forces and takes away the opportunity of many young black males of getting into university. This then continues the cycle of the black community being uneducated.
The systemic racism that I have felt hasn't necessarily come from a police officer, a judge, a teacher, or an employer. To me, the systemic racism that I felt is through the years of oppression against my great-grandma, who was in my life until I was 16, and her mother, and I'm sure many of her ancestors before her. This oppression came from the government, from the church, and from their own communities. She had seen so much and been treated so poorly throughout her entire life that she lost the ability to talk to any of our family about anything that happened to her before she had kids. My family's just now beginning to learn about our culture and about our family tree through personal ancestry research. We just found out a few years ago that we had an aunt who died in residential school at the age of 8. Canada systematically found a way to almost erase an entire side of mine and many others' families from this generation's knowledge.
I feel like I've been affected by how when I was in Windsor, I could never get a job. I'd go and apply everywhere and get interviews. I had like 4 interviews 1 year and I still didn't get a job. I felt like it was because of my name or maybe my last name. It's Oleko, it's an African name. Many people probably cannot pronounce it or just mispronounce it. And also I felt like it's because of my color. They don't usually, in some places in Windsor where there's no diversity, it's all just strictly white dominant, and that I wasn't able to get a job. But when I came to Waterloo, I was able to get a job right away. Now I've been working for a while now, but it's just weird to me because I've been in Windsor for so long all my life and I wasn't able to get a job, but I come to a whole new city that doesn't even know me, and right away I got a job.
As a status first,
back at Gryphons Center Arena, the Gryphons scoring 4 times in the second period to turn a 3-0 deficit to a 4-0 lead or 4-3 lead. Luke Kukovich just puts home a pass from Nolan DeGersey. And there you see Kukovich centering his shot right onto Nolan DeGersey's stick. That has been assist has been given to Giordano Biondi. In-house, Anthony Tabak spells the end of Anthony Popovich. Or at least this will spell the end after Liam Hamm sends it through the gaggle of bodies. And all those 4 goals, Guelph score in about 9 minutes. And then Tanner Wickware takes over with a couple of dandy saves. And then this little altercation afterwards as Jonathan Yancis, the last person you would expect in the world, finds himself on the seat of his pants. Guelph still has 3 minutes and 42 seconds on a power play. A penalty to Dalton Duhart for slashing. And then he had a few too many words for the official afterwards. And so he'll still continue to feel shame. Once again, happy you could join us in Griff Vision as part of OUA TV. I'm Jeffrey Rando. all set to go for the third period. Queens up on their bench. Guelph is not. Finally, half the squad gets up. Sticks are down. Puck is down. Third period is underway. This is Nathan Allenson. And that is an offside. Guelph battles Concordia and McGill next weekend before heading home for a pair. Meanwhile, the Queens, Gaels, are home to UQTR and TMU next weekend. But first, this one needs to reach its conclusion. Nathan Allenson will find Luka Kovicius. He'll lug it in, flip it in. And now an unsportsmanlike call, and it'll go to Luke Kukovicius. I believe he just fell on his own, but it's going to be a diving call. And Kukovicius is in a little bit of disbelief. 35 seconds into the frame. So there will be no power play here. We'll play 4-on-4. And Guelph will have an opportunity to maintain their power play once Kukovicius is freed. As Lalonde loses this to DeGuercy. DeSimone. Short pass for Allenson. DeSimone. As Drew Jackson takes a tumble. And now back quickly comes Queens. Here is Hamilton straight down Broadway. And that's one he'll want to have back. Jonah DeSimone. As Nathan Allenson was set to go off for a change. He'll gain and then reverse course, leave this to an open man and Duncan Penman. Duncan Penman looks to cut of the net. He's fended off at the point of attack by Lalonde. Penman gets it through to off to the pads of Spooner. The return pass, Penman again. This is off the stick of Renwick and goes out of play. As Duncan Penman, who played 175 OHL games with Saginaw and Mississauga, has a chance, but not before Derek Hamilton looked to score his second of the game. Trying to go glove side. He beats Wickware, but not the post, or at least can't get the puck on target to back. Cuts to the net. Poked away by Spooner. Winterton misfires. Second chance is fumbled. And back comes Hutchinson. 3-on-2 rush. Hutchinson scores! Nolan Hutchinson, his seventh of the season. This comes 4-on-4, 2-10. Into the period. Hutchinson does it by himself. The shot from the outside goes right past Wickware. And his seventh of the year for the former Nanaimo Clipper and Sudbury Wolf makes the difference. Still 20 seconds of 4-on-4 action. Robert and Renwick will get the assists on the tally in a brand new hockey game. This is Nathan Allenson, now Tristan DeYoung. DeSimone. DeYoung to DeGuercy with Kukovicius heading straight to the net. The pass is returned here for Allenson, a minute to go in this power play, which sees Guelph down one, thanks to a 4-on-4 goal. Is a high rising shot from DeGuercy. Allenson teed up, swallowed by Spooner, and he's able to collect the rebound before anyone else in white can get one past him. As a soft little pass and shanked on by Allenson, who came off last game with 2 assists. In on the draw. Camp. Robert will lose this, or Robert will lose this. Winterton raced by Robert. 22nd. Left in the power play. Stevenson pops free. Winterton loses this to Stevenson. Jack Duff past Jackson Camp and all the way on down. Tanner Wickwer wanted icing, but the opponents were shorthanded. Duhart has rejoined the play after his double minor. Longo will hook up with Lalonde. Batted in by Duhart. Taken to the net by Yancis, who drills a shot just wide. Wickwer without his twig. As the puck bobbles back out to the neutral zone, Longo is met by Doyle. Brazier, one-on-one with Lalonde. Lalonde defends him perfectly. Here is Hutchinson, the game's tying goal scorer. All 8 goals have been in that net in this contest. 4:30 and ticking away. Gone in the third. Enright will slingshot this back down. And Renwick will take over. Renwick makes a move. And we'll flip this in deep. Ham takes a hit, makes the play. Michaud steps in the way of Biondi, who is hammered on a cross check down, and it's going to be a penalty coming to Jack Duff. Penalty comes, 5:11 into the frame. As Biondi tries to make a move, swerve around Duff, and he's hit in a sore area. And the Queens captain will sit for 2 minutes or less. Guelph will go to their 6th power play, 1-for-5. Allenson for DeYoung, and again DeGuercy. DeYoung, Allenson is blocked on the way through by Paquette, but Spooner's there to keep the pad hard to the ground, hard to the ice. And is there to make the save. Again, Guelph's puck movement around the top. The shot from the point from Nathan Allenson finds its way on through eventually, but Aiden Spooner, the business major, makes the save and keeps this game. And a 4-4 scoreline. DeYoung for Allenson. And DeYoung again to the top is Kukovicius. As Allenson will disperse. DeSimone offers this to Kukovicius. Kukovicius will hand this off for DeYoung. He'll assign it to DeGuercy. Wanted to take the shot, had to settle it down first. DeYoung, now Allenson. Allenson in front for Kukovicius. The puck will bobble in behind the red line, and Tournay will help finish the rest of the job of the Queens Gaels. Under a minute now. Now, three quarters, or two-thirds, excuse me, of the power play remains, or is left. Camp for Winterton and Tabak. Camp's got it again. Camp changes the angle, switches with Tabak, brings it back to the top for Camp. Penman will tee this up, knock down the rebound, they score! Nolan Forster responds with the power play goal. It's his third of the year. And Guelph retakes the lead. This time 5-4. Tabak and DeYoung. The final blow is Penman. And Forster finishes the job, the former member of the Teton, who extends his point streak to four games. Enright, as Brazier will get rid of this. Brazier quickly on and on the forecheck. Forster from Tabak and Penman is the scoring play. Wick wears out of his cage as Renwick is the trailer off the turnover from Dalton Duhart. Gordon can't keep it out. Queens again vying for a game-tying goal. The lead in shots, 36-29. But the Gryphons now have a 5-4 lead thanks to Nolan Forster's power play marker. Guelph's power play red hot as of late. Forster makes a move, cuts to the net, leaves us in front. Loose puck, Forster again, and he scores again! Make it two for Nolan Forster. This at the 8:02 mark. Turned over behind the cage. The loose puck finds Forster and he chips it past the glove hand of Aiden Spooner, and Guelph has a 2-goal lead. Allison will leave this for DeYoung. DeYoung in his own zone. Nolan Forster unassisted, 8:02. The goals come 1:13 apart. That is the difference. DeGersey swings and misses. Penman, hard pass, links up with Camp. Tone. Poke checks this just to Duncan Penman. He'll ring it off the end glass. Approaching halfway in the third period, Guelph en route looking for a much needed win. Started the year with two losses. Maybe a third consecutive victory in their sights. And would be a very, very much needed one against one of the Eastern Conference's best here in the OUA. Deflected in by Forster. Maybe, possibly, back-to-back games with a hat trick for this Gryphon squad. Forster now on hat trick watch. Winterton takes this over. Forster's in front of the goal. Winterton driven away from the cage by Stevenson. Still got it. Puts it on the stick of Ham. Ham tees it up and into the right-hand catching glove of Aiden Spooner, who gets the whistle with 10:18 to go in the final frame. Forrester with a two-goal, one-assist night. Those each coming on the Guelph's last three goals. Forrester had a total of 12 points as a member of the Teton. He's already got six in five games. Perrick gets hammered in the face with the puck, but he's back to his feet. Enright links up with Brazier. He'll continue the chain with Gordon. And now Queens trying to use their tracking and their transition to their success. Duff will join the play. Infiltrates the zone. That's blocked by Liam Hamm. Guelph already down a defender in Ashton Reeser, who blocked a shot against Laurier. Here's Gordon. Lost it to Yancis. Gordon again. He'll send it the rest of the way. Guelph will get a line change in. 9 1/4 to go in the third. Jeffrey Brando with you. You are watching Gryphons and it's part of OUA TV. So happy you could join us no matter what part of the world you are tuning in from. Ferguson breaks his stick on the block shot off the twig of Jonathan Yancis, and Jonah DeSimone will flip this in. Lalonde harassed by Kukovicius. DeGersey has it ripped from his grasp by Duhart. Puck stays in the offensive zone, pursued by Penman, and now Lalonde links up with Hutchinson, who originally tied the game at 4-4 here early in the third. Guelph with two goals, both by Nolan Forrester, as Cousins is met by DeYoung. Tabak, still that loose stick from Ian Ferguson on the ice. This is Forrester, the former GOGHL All-Rookie Team in 2019-2020. DeBack. And now Penman bugs Cap. It'll be Longo who will chip it in. Jackson Camp will put this on the stick of Jacob Winterton. And he'll just hammer it off the wall. Guelph trying to clear it every opportunity that they can. Quick line changes as well. Here's Robert. Robert, back pass for Yancis, or beg your pardon, it's Michaud, but it's too far out of his reach. Biondi comes flying in. This is Jack Duff. Isaac Enright steals it away. Wilson with Biondi. Biondi shoots, he scores! Gio Biondi, his first of the year! And the Gryphons take a 7-4 lead. Isaac Enright feeds this towards Griffin Wilson, and it's Gio Biondi who finishes the job. And the Sudbury native has his first of the year, the former J. Ross Robertson Cup champion of his own in 2022. Off the glass as Gryphons now have 7 minutes to kill before they can celebrate a third straight victory. But Queens, you know, will not give up. Isaac Enright off the stick of and skates of Brazier. Gordon. Ethan Doyle has Brazier in front. Gordon can't handle the rebound. Back to the point, it's DeYoung. He'll flip this in for Brazier. Brazier now, and Stevenson will engage. Ethan Doyle will take this. Chip back for Brazier. Gordon offers this again to Hunter Brazier, the Valcaron native. And it's stopped by Aiden Spooner. Hutchinson late in a rush. Puts this right on the skates of Tanner Wickware and Allinson. DeGersey eludes a hit from Cousins and will fling this in deep. Cap, Kukovic is in there. Kukovic knocks down Cap, and that will be a penalty for tripping. Kukovic is his second penalty, or third penalty of the game. That comes 14:45 into the frame. So Guelph will look to take another penalty kill here. Third power play of the game for the Queens Gaels. 2 minutes to do something to deal with. Again, another false faceoff. Doyle is knocked down off the draw, but he's back to his feet. Hamilton for Yancis. A try from the Gaels as Robert was looking for Hamilton in front. Robert's got it again. Alex Robert accepts a return pass. We'll skip this to the lawn. Switches with Hamilton. To the net, Wickware with a glove save. A quarter of the power play gone. Hamilton tries to set this out in front where Jonathan Yancis and his big body tries to do the work in front of the deflection. As mentioned, 50 goals in the OHL. He scored 97 of them. Part of the 2022 first All-Star team in the OUA East and a FISU gold medalist. Lalonde off the one draw, fakes, Robert takes, Robert takes, blocked nicely by Ham. Robert again, back door is Hamilton, there's a drive. That's patted away by Wickware. Queens using a puck movement that they're trying to do, but it's relieved as Hamilton's pass goes over the stick of Lalonde. A minute left to go in the power play. 4:45 left to go in the third. Rushing in is Jonathan Yancis. This is Yancis to the lawn. To the line and out. Power play change. Longo eludes a hit from Penman. Cousins can't, or Michaud can't elude the hit from Penman. And Queens will have to get back onside, and they do. A quarter of the penalty left as Longo shot hits the short side part of the cage. Four to go. Michaud in there. Finally, the jewel pops free. Here is Hutchinson to the top. Pyrrhic. Pyrrhic shoots into the bodies. The rebound, they score! Nolan Hutchinson has got his second of the period, eighth of the season, and Queens with 3:54 to go still has a life as they notch a power play marker. Offense, the name of the game in this one. And they both teams really want to play, at least Guelph does for certain, a defensive style. They'll take the 7 goals, but they might not take the 5 goals allowed. Make that 5 goals in the last 2 third periods allowed. Something Guelph will have to work on all year if they want not only a playoff spot, but to challenge in the OUA playoffs. It is Michaud and Pyrrhic with the assists. on Hutchinson's goal as he's fishing for a third. Longo is there. Longo makes a move. Tries to evade Winterton. Drop pass for Duhart. And we're going to have a penalty called. As Longo runs, interference is the tripping call officially. So Longo will sit in the box for two or less. As there you see the stick in the legs, bringing his opponent to the ice. The penalty comes at the 17-16 mark. Guelph will go to their seventh power play. They have scored twice already. Kukovic just wins this draw too clearly. And now DeJong will have to race back and elude Robert. Nathan Allinson will allocate this to Kukovic. And he'll take the opportunity to fling it in deep. Back again come the Queens Gaels, looking to score shorthanded. Literally almost every time they're down to a fourth player. DeGersey. And a battle with Tone. We'll leave this for Allinson. He'll continue the chain to DeJong. Forwarded for DeSimone. He'll just toss this in deep. Met by Stevenson with under 2 minutes to go now in regulation. We keep an eye on Aiden Spooner just in case Queens decides to pull. A minute left in the power play. DeJong settles, cradles, brings it in, takes the hit, makes the play. Against his numerical counterpart in Stevenson. And now Duhart is screaming up against the offensive zone, blue line. They are onside, not for long, as Winterton is forced back. 80 seconds to go in the third. Guelph trying to play keep away from a shorthanded Queen squad. Cross corner dump. Camp is there. For Tabak. Tabak. Sarah's this for Camp. 1 minute to go. In regulation. Winterton. Penman. A shot. Blocked by Duff. He'll spring an attack with 5 seconds left. Yantis will knife that in, but it will go into the netting on the far side. Again, Aiden Spooner stays in the goal as Queens will make the change, as well as the Gryphons will have a center ice face off. Doyle, Gordon, and Brazier, with Allinson and DeJong, responded to by Yancis, Hutchinson, Perrick Lalonde, and Trevor Longo will rejoin the play once he's out of the penalty box. They'll change the angle of the faceoff to just outside where the Gryphons' defensive zone is. And Gordon will sweep this in. There's Spooner, leaving this for the lawn. Will he go with the play? Yes, he will. But he's stopped as Ethan Doyle is hit with the clearing attempt. The rebound scores! Jonathan Yancis with 22.1 on the clock. And once again, this game is not over yet. Jonathan Yancis hits third of the season, capitalizes off a Guelph turnover where they had a chance to get it out, and they could not do so. So we will have a timeout by the Queens Gaels as they look to set up and make a play with 22.1 to go. Six goals in that third period. Nolan Hutchins started the party at 2:10. Nolan Forrester scored his first at 6:49, followed by a marker at 8:02. Gio Biondi thought what is now the game-winning goal at 12:50, followed by two Queens goals as Hutchinson gets his second of the frame, and Jonathan Neantis has just collected his third of the year. Pass Tanner Wickware. Gryphons lead by one. Goaltender out for Queens. Kukovicius, Gordon, Ham, or I beg your pardon, is Penman and Camp to back out there as they're using two centermen off the defensive zone. 12 to go to the line. It'll come out. Gordon speeding to the red line. Gordon heading towards the net. He'll fire it just wide, but it'll do just enough as the time will expire and the Guelph Gryphons survive with an old-fashioned shootout of 7-6. Your final score, enjoyable for the fans, not so much for the coaches. Both teams will want to try to calm it down as they continue on for the season. Again, three goals each in that period. If your name was Nolan, you had a pretty good period. Two by Hutchinson, two by Forrester. And that does it for the end of the game. Gio Biondi will get the game-winning goal on his first of the year. It's been a long day for us here at Gryphons, and bringing you a doubleheader worth of action with both the men's and women's hockey teams. So we thank you for tuning in. No matter what part of the world you are tuning us from, our next home game for the men is November 3rd as the Ontario Tech Ridgebacks make their way into town. You can watch all the games live here on OUA TV. Until we meet again, I'm Jeffrey Brando. So happy that you could spend at least a little bit part of your Saturday with us. That's it from Guelph. We build you a fond farewell. We'll be right back.